morning.
Good morning.
Praise God to be in the house one more again this morning. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to get started. Our pastor and first lady will be here shortly. But we're going to go and get started this morning. Precious Father, we come thank you this morning. We thank you for another day that was promised to us, Lord. We thank you for allowing us to wake up this morning. Not only allowing us to wake up this morning, Lord, we woke up in our right mind. All of our limbs were in use. And we just want to say thank you this morning, Lord. Lord, we thank you for the leaders of this great congregation, our pastor and First Lady Taylor. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for Brother Wendell, Minister Wendell. We thank you for Evangelist Alcine. Lord, we thank you for Mother Burks. Thank you for HOD, Lord. Have your way in this place this morning, Lord. We ask you to just come on in this building and have your way this morning, Lord. Lord, we thank you for the ones that are on the way that have not made it yet, but we also thank you for the ones that are here, Lord. Because they turn out to be come closer and closer to you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for our visitors this morning. I ask you just put your loving arm and protection all around everyone in this place, Lord. Lord, we ask you just to touch this nation, Lord. Touch the president's mind. Touch the Congress mind. Touch everybody's mind, Lord. That they all be one accord. Jesus, I thank you this morning right now. Hallelujah. Lord, we just come and ask you to just have thy own way in this place, Lord. Continue to pour out your blessing. Lord, it was so wonderful to be here this morning. Now, Lord, we just ask you to continue to strengthen each and one of us, Lord, that we might go on in your word. Lord, I thank you for the safe travel for my sisters, my niece and nephews, Lord. Lord, I thank you for my other niece and nephew that you saw fit to let them see one more year, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I ask you to go to Dallas, Texas and touch right up in there right now. Touch my family. Touch every last one of them up there, Lord. Lord, touch my cousin Teresa. Heal her body right now. I plead the blood of Jesus all over her right now, Lord Jesus. I plead the blood over her, Lord, right now. Hallelujah. Lord, I just want to ask you these things in your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 We're going to stand and do our reading. Just a moment. I'm going to limit the spots to get you a paper. How is everyone doing this morning?
Beautiful.
That's wonderful, wonderful, wonderful.
Good.
It is a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more again. Amen. It is a wonderful blessing that God saw fit to allow us to be here today. On the count of three, we'll all read it together. One, two, three. Enlarge the place of thy tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of thine habitation. Spare not, lengthen thy cords, and strengthen thy stake. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles, and make the desolated cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither thou shalt be confounded, for thou shalt not put which hurts to shame, for thou shalt forget the shame you, and shall not remember the reproach of thy widowhood anymore. Amen. Something good is about to happen. Because this is my day.
My day.
Something good.
Something good
is about to happen.
Is about to happen.
Because this
is
my day.
My day.
Now give it to somebody else and point to them. Say something good.
Something good
is about to happen.
Is about to happen.
Because this is
your day.
Now give God the biggest praise that you have.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. We thank God. We're going to continue to move. Our pastor and first lady should be here momentarily. But we're going to keep on going on in the name of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Minister Spots, did you have those visitors' cards?
I gave them down.
I need them. Thank God for Adam and Nicole this morning.
Amen. God bless you this morning, God.
We God bless you. Thank you. You could have went to any plant church, but we so proud and grateful that you came to be with us this morning. On behalf of our pastor and first lady and their absent, on behalf of myself, Minister Shepherd, and Minister Spot, we welcome you to Powerhouse Ministries, where nothing but love and the truth of God is told up in here. Powerhouse says, you are welcome here. You are part of God's family. The table's prepared and you know that we care. Come on, you are welcome. Come on, you are loved. Come on, you are welcome in this place. We welcome you to Powerhouse Ministries, and by the power night, y'all feel free to have whatever God put on your heart to do. At this time, we're going to go on and tell the goodness of God, what God has done for you. If you have anything that you would like to share this morning on the greatness and goodness of God, you may do so at this time.
First, giving honor to God, His precious Son, Jesus Christ, who died for my sins, not only for my sins, but for everyone's sins in here, right? Also, I want to give homage and praise and honor to the precious Holy Spirit that lives, moves, and abides in each and every one of us. I just want to say, guys, that it is truly a magnificent day. This is a day that the Lord has made, and we all shall rejoice and be glad in it. But I want to tell you about this week of mine. This week of mine, it's been something. It's been a week of increase. It's been a week of prosperity. But also yesterday, that old deceptor tried to come in and tried to snatch all that away from me. I'm going to tell you why, I'm going to tell you how. But yesterday, I called one of our doctors to work, and he had a little attitude about it. But guess what? That ain't the bad part, Mr. Shepherd. The bad part is that I got in God's way, right? Mm-hmm. And instead of immediately praying over the situation, right? Mm-hmm. I got in God's way and pondered on things, I would say.
Wow.
And not giving God an opportunity to come in there and fix things.
That's right.
Right? So I pounded on things. In doing that, I got out the van and got to work. And immediately, God let me know. You're in my way, Wendell.
Not at
all. Right? I get in, as soon as I get, I didn't take 3 steps in the door. Here comes somebody running a buggy over my foot. Okay, God. I get to the cash register. Here I am, I'm making all kind of mistakes on this cash register. Right? And then it hit me. I say, Lord, I see, I'm in your way. And I told one of the members, one of my brothers, hey, Russell, look, hold the cash register, son. I got to go do this. So I go to the bedroom. I go to start praying.
Come on.
Lord, forgive me, Lord, for being in your way. Forgive me, Lord, for not turning this situation over to you. Forgive me, Lord, for standing in your way to do what needs to be done.
Uh-huh.
So when I came full circle, when I repented from that, right? Guess what? No more mistakes on the gas. But wait a minute. You talked about elevation when that was Wednesday.
Uh-huh.
Right?
The whole law.
Now, after I didn't gave things over to God, right? Here it is now. I'm gonna be in the pastor's jury.
Watch out.
Hey!
Look at God.
Wait a minute, that ain't all. My people are going to be giving a family reunion here in Houston, Texas on the 21st of September.
Uh-huh.
Don't have to pay for that ticket.
Well.
Ain't got to pay for no motel room.
Come on.
Ain't nothing but the goodness
of God.
Right? And I'm going to tell you guys, like I always say, I serve a God of no respected person.
That's right.
What he has done for me, he is more than able and capable of doing for anyone else, but you have to let
him. Amen.
See, I tried to get in God's way. I started trying to do God's job. And what I found out, my arms are too short to box with God.
Huh.
Can't nobody fix a problem like God can. Can no one open doors like God can.
Come on.
Right? No, can nobody reconcile things like God can.
That's right.
Man, I'm telling you, he is wonderful. He is wonderful. I got to give him all the, I got to give him his props.
Yeah.
And by how I give him his props, I tell him, thank you, Jesus.
Yeah,
thank
come
you,
on.
Lord, for being whom you are. Thank you for being that magnificent and almighty Lord and Savior in my life.
Come on.
So, I'm like, I'm just referring to everyone in here. Let God have it. Stay out of God's way. Let it be God. Because when you let it be God, God will come in there and do what needs to be done. God will come in there and fix any problem that mm-hmm. you may be going through. Financial, physical, mental, whatever the situation may be, give it to Jesus and leave it there. Like I say, my name is at the cross.
Yeah.
And my name is going to continue to be at the cross. Not only my name, but when the Lord spots, it's going to continuously be at the cross. Because I know at the cross is where I first started life. And all the burdens of my heart rolled away.
Come on.
It was there I found out that I received my sight. All the rest of my days. God bless you this morning, church, and may God keep you.
Amen. All right. Amen. Amen. Is there anyone else that'd like to tell the goodness of God this morning? Go ahead, brother.
We went to garage sale there in Coast Our Town yesterday.
Yes.
And we bought like $25 worth of stuff, and she ended up giving us like a lot of stuff. I mean, we got probably 50 t-shirts, about a bunch of pants, and all kinds of stuff. She just
and more stuff.
Just gave them to us. That kind of was hard to hear. Why don't you take it?
Won't God do it? Yeah. Won't he make a way out of no way? Hallelujah. We thank God. Praise you, Brother Adam. Is there anyone else? But Brad?
Just like me, I went to a garage sale Friday, and there was a lady there who was struggling. She just talked to her husband about 2 weeks ago.
Uh-huh.
Then after about a week after that, she lost her son in a car wreck. And she says, I don't know what to do. And all of a sudden, I started praying for her.
That was God. God led you to do that for her. Thank you, Jesus. But Brad, do you have anything you want to say this morning? All right. Thank God for our First Lady and Pastor and our evangelist coming in this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank God. Thank God.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are y'all doing this morning?
Good morning. How are you doing, First Lady?
First Lady,
we have Sister Nicole and Brother Adam this morning.
Bless you. Bless you. Welcome.
That's our First Lady Taylor, and this is our pastor here, Pastor Taylor. Amen. Is there anyone, First Lady, would you like to say anything this morning for the goodness of Jesus?
Yes. First of all, I'm going to apologize for my tardiness. I'm slow this morning. First of all, I give honor to God and to Pastor Taylor and to Minister Shepherd and Minister Spock and Minister Alcine, Pastor Disciple, and members and visitors. It's just a blessing to be back here in the house of the Lord. I always look forward on Sunday morning coming to worship the Lord. I don't care if I gotta worship all by myself. I feel good when I step up in here and just knowing the presence of the Lord is in here and ready to enjoy Him. Ready to God proved something yesterday, just how good He is. He took care of us, I let Pastor explain it. But He took care of us, I mean, it's just like He was there in person and took care of us and took care of my dad and all like that, my dad and all that stuff. And I just want to say that trust God.
Uh-huh.
Whatever you need, I'm a witness.
Come on.
And God will give it to you. If you trust
me. That's right.
And you can't live like a junkyard dog.
Hmm.
And then ask Him for it. You got to live in the image of Him. You got to walk it and talk it. And I guarantee you God will tote you. He will love on you. And He will supply all of your needs like He said. Pay your bill, feed you, watch over you when you sleep, and party with you when you pray.
Come on. My.
I don't know about nobody else, but I feel that way. Anyway, God bless you, God keep you. And just ask you all to continue to pray for me and the pastor. And I will pray for you all that we all grow stronger in the Lord. God bless you, God.
Amen. Amen. Well, we thank God for that testimony. Amen. Sister Belinda coming in this morning. We thank God for her this morning. Do one of you ladies have a testimony this morning? Amen.
Because we are always getting tested. And you got to show God, hey,
I can pass this test as long as I know you got a hold of my hand helping me. Because I have not tried quite a bit this week. But you know what? I passed the test. People are going to try you, mess with your attitude, do things they know you don't like. Do things they know you don't like being around. Do things they know you don't allow in your house. But you got to stand firm on what you say you're going to have over your house, the right spirit. Because I always tell people, if I see a drama king or drama queen spirit in you, turn around my gate and go back home. That's just how I've gotten to where I'm so into the great peace that I'm enjoying in the Lord. I don't want anybody disturbing my peace.
I don't care who you are.
Because that peace of mind, that peace in your spirit, that peace that you feel you can relax at home, away from all ignorance, that's a good feeling.
Amen.
And when you feel good like that, you don't want nobody disturbing.
All right.
Even the devil. You got to put your foot on his head and let him know, hey, not today. You messed with the wrong one. You must have forgotten who I am. I'm a child of God.
Uh-huh.
I'm a daughter of a king.
That's right.
You better leave me alone.
You don't know how to hear.
And even at school, I've had to face some things. I had my first little incident with little devil in the classroom by me. I bet she calmed down.
I bet she
when
did,
when she
too.
Saw I wasn't finna stick to her level. You always got somebody got a smart mouth and a bad spirit in the class and disrupt class. And all I told her, I said, some of us did come here to learn. I said, you're disturbing the ones who want to learn. The teacher just looked at me like, I don't know what caused me to say that, but she has been a disturbance in class, taking up at least 15, 20 minutes of our class time. We come there to learn. We didn't come here and hurry your complaining and your cussing. You're telling people off in class that you don't like. We don't want to hear that.
Uh-huh.
So I whispered in my teacher's ear, which one of my teachers is one of my GED teachers, Miss Richardson. I said, I'm going to the restroom and go pray. She said, go on, baby. She said, we need it in this classroom today. When I came back, it was peaceful in there, and guess what? She left. The class where everybody was able to learn, I said, she tried me. All because I said that, but you know what? I just thank God for the right spirit he instilled in us. And y'all that let him lead you with the Holy Spirit, keep letting him do it, because it's a good feeling when you obey.
Yes.
You get not only blessed, God is smiling at you because you're obeying him and not letting the flesh take over.
Yes.
And that just makes me feel so good waking up knowing that I put a smile on his face.
Amen.
But y'all continue to pray for me. I go strong in the Lord. And I have one more good thing. I passed all my progress tests.
I went up
another level.
All right now.
I got my math test part 2 to take. And that's the hardest part. But I know all that study I'm doing ain't in vain.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Thank God for you. Well, we're going to get a song. After that song, we're going to turn it into the hands of our pastor. Amen.
Amen.
And we're going to keep on moving in God's hand. Amen. How many want to go home on the morning train? How many want to go home on the morning train? In order to go home on the morning train, you got to get right, church. Oh, get right, church, and let's go home. That bad thing, get your load. Wanna be told, won't be alone.
Just put me
back. I'll be gone. I'm on the road.
Say it's
shot.
Nobody's there.
Yeah, come on now. Hallelujah.
I'm going home on the morning train.
Oh, come on,
baby. I'm going home. I'm going home. I'm going home on the morning train.
If you don't believe,
I'm giving you cake. Follow me down to the Jordan stream. Step in the water was cold. She went for me, but not my soul.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. None other than Pastor James Taylor. Amen?
Amen.
Give the Lord and God great bless you.
Will it all stand?
There's a scripture verse I say to my kids a lot. It can be found in James 4:2, and it says,
God bless you this morning. This prayer is standing.
Often.
Stay right there, Shepherd. We're going to give a little bit of something else in a little bit. Father, we thank you. We praise you. We thank you for being God. Forgive us for our sin and wash us clean. Thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let the people receive from you what we need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Give God the biggest praise you got. Look at somebody and say, it's so good.
It's so good.
To see you.
To see you.
Thank God.
Thank God.
You have not.
You have not.
Lost your mind.
Lost your mind.
Thank God.
Thank God.
I got my mind.
I got my mind.
Say thank God.
Thank God.
To know Jesus.
To know Jesus. He's
the Savior. Y'all so weak. Don't sit down. Don't sit down. Don't sit down.
He's the Savior.
Oh, I thank God for y'all this morning. Y'all are awesome, amen. Y'all are so awesome. I praise God for you. Mr. Shepherd, give me Emmanuel. We need to just continue to usher the Lord and welcome him in his presence in this place. I want you to just get your mind on the Lord and think about the power of God with you, Emmanuel. Amen.
They tried to get that window up, get that application over there, but they couldn't get it up. So they're going to try again tomorrow. We speaking that that application going to be in there. Amen. Yeah, ain't nobody but quiet.
Amen.
Mr. Man of the Lord Emmanuel. You all have to put another fan over there. Do what you got to do, amen. It's got the one in the front of us. Put it in the front of us, amen. Turn it up a little bit for me. Get your man on the Lord.
Know God is with you.
Amen. Amen.
I know y'all tired this morning. You ought to know what I've been through. Amen.
Right,
I'll just say amen and go back home. Amen. Amen.
Come on,
pal.
Come on.
Amen. 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 Glory to God. Let me tell you, God is so good. when you know God is on your side, you got to tell somebody, wait a minute, I'm not going to leave you until I tell you how good God is. Amen. I know how good he is. Amen. I know he's a God that will never fail us. Amen.
Well.
I don't know your story, but I know my story. Amen.
Come on.
The Lord has added to my story each day. Amen.
That's right.
He added to my story, But I just thank God for all y'all that are here. Amen. And I've seen Dr. Shepherd, who did an awesome job. Amen. Amen. Mr. Wendell. Amen. Awesome. Amen. Praise God, him and Mr. Brother Stanley. And we got Adam Lockwich. Am I right?
Lockwich.
Amen. And Sister Nicole Clinton. Amen.
Amen.
God bless y'all. We welcome you to the Powerhouse Ministry. Give them a great Powerhouse
welcome. Hallelujah!
Yay! Welcome.
Where y'all from?
Timpson, Texas.
Timpson.
I was down in the other neighborhood close yesterday. I was in Tenny Hall yesterday. I didn't go to Fort Worth Lab, but I was in I went to Timpson. I went to Tenny Hall on the car. I come from Logan's folks. Amen. Louisiana. Joaquin. Amen.
That's where I'm born and raised.
Longview, Texas. Amen. Y'all built a new school there. I was down in Longview trying to get some of that fish down off the river down there. Amen. Catfish down there on Longview. Amen. Oh, I was down there at Catfish House. Amen. And on my way, I saw Minister Shepherd. I thank God for that. It was First Lady Taylor. Amen. We thank God for our First Lady. Amen.
Amen.
Just praise God for her. Amen. It's just a blessing to have all y'all that are here, amen. And my singing man here. they call you Junior, don't you?
Yeah.
Maurice, amen. Thank God for you today, amen. Amen. Yeah, I got you. Amen. This is Shepherd. I got my car out the shop, my Lincoln, amen. I've been had it from, sit up for about 6 years, amen. And first lady just told me, go on, get that car fixed. Put a lot of money in it, got it fixed. So I said, well, I'm going to drive it to Louisiana and try it out. Picked my dad up in Carson, went on over where the Logan's boat. Just drive it back. I was driving pretty good there. The folks were going around me. Really, lady, I said, well, I ain't going to worry about it today. So on my way coming back, for some reason, I just stepped on it a little bit, coming back. Amen.
Uh-huh.
Just step on. I said, I'm going to let you know this old boy can stretch out a little bit. Amen. Got almost a long period. Pop! A hole. All this stuff I done put on this car. A hole. But poof. Smoke went everywhere. Amen. What happened? The fan belt broke. I thought they were going to put all these fan belts. One fan belt broke on the alternator. Amen. It knocked my hose off. And it made where all the water, the antifreeze coming out of this smoking like a train. Pulled in over there at the Elderville Fire Department for some reason. I pulled in there. Didn't know nobody was there. Young man came out, put my hose back on, gave me water, and I got back to Longview to Lakeport to the Dairy Queen. And it went, it went hot again. I said, Lord, the belt they on, that's what's wrong. That's what's gonna make it run hot. That didn't cost too much to be trying to make it crack ahead.
I know you right.
Amen. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So the first lady said, I go across the road over there. The first lady walked all the way over to the Family Dollar and got me some antifreeze, amen. But I kept saying, somebody probably gonna give her a ride back. I just kept feeling it. Here she come back in a Jeep, so tall on while she got up in it. The guy got out, and he looked, and he said, man, if I had some tools, I could help you. And he called, stove's almost closed, everybody closed. He called somebody, one of the parts though, went and picked the belt up for me. Didn't let me give him no money. The belt wasn't cheap, and put it on, I helped him a little bit, put it on. The car made it in good, amen?
Uh-huh.
I'm just going to take it and let them do a little, you know, a little car made it work to make sure everything's all right. But God showed me both times I'm with you. Did you hear me? Uh-huh. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Come on.
He would take care of
four times somebody came out by Dr. Ashton and took care, they took care of it. You hear me?
Come on.
And the man said, I'm Pentecostal. Now, when I come to church, I want to have a good, I said, man, you come on, we got the Holy Ghost up for that. Amen.
Come on.
So y'all, see, what God showed me something, that I'm with you. That's why I love Emmanuel. He said, God is with you. You got to know, I don't care where you at. I was so glad we didn't get trapped off in the woods in Louisiana. With my dad back off in there, it could have broke back off in there. But it broke back almost close to home. Y'all didn't hear what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Sometimes, God, I told friend that I don't know why I speed it up. Sometimes you speed up to get you to a destination so it can break so you can get some help. Y'all.
That's right. Come
that's
on.
Why we got to speed up now. That's why you got to quit. When you got that urge in you to do something, you better do it.
You better do it.
The spirit be leading you. And the spirit will lead other folk. You don't know why you do what you do. Amen.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm telling y'all, I know God is with me. If I don't know about that, but I don't go no further. I'm going to let you know God is here.
Yep.
Sometimes it looks like it ain't nothing working out for you. He showed me yesterday. I'm with you. Maybe that's my test yesterday, my try. And see, the thing about it, I was trying to help other folk. Sometimes when you help other folks, God will turn around and help you.
That's right.
Y'all,
that's good. Come on, Pastor.
Right.
Sometimes you help so many people, you get exhausted. You ain't got no strength to do nothing else. And you say, I ain't doing it no more. I'm tired. I'm finna sit down. But God will bless you. I got to see my uncle. That's a pastor. He's preaching today. And he asked me, how come I didn't get a chance to make it a revival? I said, man, I've just been tired up, man. And he's preaching today. And I thank God for my uncle. And I thank God for my uncles and pastors. I praise God for all of them. Amen, but I told my wife, it's amazing, I would have been connected with them like I was, but God sent me kind of in a different direction, amen, to reach you, you, and you.
That's right. That's right, Dad.
Amen, that's right.
Lord, what are you doing today?
My.
Y'all ain't catching it today.
We got
you. Catching the pastor.
When the Lord is working for you, it's hard to explain this thing.
That's right.
Yeah, it don't take a lot of people to sit up in here. It don't. But I'm going to tell you something. Don't knock where a lot of people are at church. Don't talk about it. Pray for them.
Uh-huh.
And don't knock when a lot of people are not at a place. Don't talk about them. Pray for them.
Yep.
And show up, don't knock where you at.
There you go.
Because I know what life is supposed to be full, and I know what it's like to be empty.
Come on.
I know it's like to be a few people. But God told me don't say small no more. Because I'm saying this large ministry.
Come on now.
Because when you're doing the will of God, that's a large thing. Y'all
ain't
getting
it. That's right. Come on.
See, a lot of people got a big ministry, but they thought you see it big, but they ain't doing all the things they need to do. And if folks got small ministry, they ain't doing all they need to do. But when you do all that God tell you to do, you're doing a large thing. Amen.
Amen.
All right, we're going to go to the word, because y'all don't want to hear no more.
Come on, God, stop.
Well, we talk about today. We're talking about today. I want y'all to catch this when I'm telling you, okay? Do spiritual things. Say do.
Do.
Spiritual things.
Spiritual things.
Amen. A lot of people are doing natural things and not spiritual things.
All right.
If the Lord tell you, and you on your way to pay your water bill, and he said, and you know your cutoff notice got to be paid, you got to be paid by 3 o'clock, and it's 12:30, and you got to eat lunch, and you promise somebody you're going to be with them at 1:30, you better go do what God tell you to do. If God tell you to go a totally different direction, you better go. Because there's a reason for you going there. Sometimes you save your life and don't know it. Y'all quiet.
Come on.
Sometimes you save somebody else's life. Sometimes you help somebody do something. You don't know who you're going to be going the other direction. Amen.
Right.
Maurice didn't have an idea he was going to be in Longview. But God sent him here. One of them didn't have a clue he was going to be on a Greyhound bus.
Huh.
But he did.
Right.
And look at him now.
If
anything I seen, didn't know why she come in that office that night. But I thank God for Sister Stanley and the Porter Jays for coming here, amen, and bringing those children. They came here, amen. Remember that day, Sister Warren come here that morning and we prayed for y'all. Remember that? I thank God for y'all coming here to help the house of disciples. Didn't know y'all were coming to be a part of Powerhouse. And then from that, the children came, and from that, as is the man that I seen came through y'all coming here. Amen. So God used you to get her here.
You didn't catch that.
And then God used her to get her sister here, the one that died, and get her family here. So you got to catch that, amen.
Come on.
And then God got Shepherd here. Minister Shepherd, amen. Amen. Going to the store buying food, didn't know that was going to be the way of getting him here. Didn't know I was going to run into him there. Saw him and his mother there all the time, shopping, amen. Now I say a few things to him and he keep on going, amen. But the thing, I saw the man was riding on the scooter. Now I'm watching him walk. That's a God. I watched the man trim down, amen, weight-wise. Y'all didn't hear me, amen. This man couldn't even walk, pardon. But now look at him. Now he bounced around, dancing and shouting, God and trimmed him down. By me going over that house that day, I met First Lady. I didn't know I was going to meet her, amen. I mean, I know I was going to meet her later on, but I started that by me going paying my sister insurance, I met her, amen. You never know what God got in plan for you, amen. So we need to know it's spiritual, amen. You need to follow the Spirit, amen. Do spiritual things, amen.
All right.
Come on. We're going to the Word today.
Excuse me, Pastor, before you we can get started. I'm asking the church to be with me. One of my cousins, that was my aunt that was just on the phone, and one of my closest cousins, right? I have many of them, but me and her, we have a special bond. She suffered a heart attack this morning. She's in a hospital out there in Baton Rouge, but she died. Her mama is on her way up out there now to check up on her. That's her youngest child. My aunt's youngest. My aunt that's staying in my house in New Orleans, that's her youngest daughter. And if it wasn't for her, if it wasn't for my cousin and my aunt, I wouldn't have no house. And that was the one that was taking care of all the taxes
really?
In the house. And she's in Baton Rouge. She was at this time things were going on. She was residing.
Well, we're gonna pray right now for her. What's her name?
Yes. Her name is Patrice Freeman.
What I want you to do, write her name down.
Yes.
Bring it to me.
Yes, sir.
And then we're gonna put it in the box. I want all the church to get ready to pray. We're gonna pray right now, because I know God can heal.
Yes, he can.
Write her name down,
yes,
and fold it up and put it in my hand. We're going to pray right now.
Because
you don't know my sermon today, it's about healing. You see, when you read it today, you're going to see it's about healing. And so what God did, he just confirmed before I told y'all where to go. Amen?
All right.
And what God has proven everything to me, I don't need him to prove that. He already approved and confirmed to me, Shepherd, everything that I need to know. He got us,
amen.
He got us. Man.
Yes,
I don't think y'all heard me.
Thank you, Lord.
Did you hear him say spiritual thing? Did you see this man say we need? A lot of times they wouldn't say that. They just sit there and wouldn't say that. I know it's an honor with will you do church, but when somebody's sick, man, and it's a bad deal, you tell them you got to have help, amen.
That's right.
Now, you in some churches, they wouldn't let you get up there close and say nothing to the pastor.
Hmm.
Amen. You have to get to the ushers and all that, and you wouldn't get nothing. Amen. All right, come on, Wendell, come on down here so you can stand and speak with me for a minute. Everybody that believes by God, and that can get a prayer through.
Yes.
Somebody come and touch his shoulder. Let him know God's here.
Yes.
Let him know everything going to be all right.
Yes.
Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We speak over trees right now. In the name of Jesus, Lord, forgive for every sin, deliver and set free. Save a soul first, you're not saved, and fill her with your spirit. Now, Lord, you're able to heal because you hung on the cross, you hung on that tree. And by every stripe that you took is for our healing. And the blood that come out of your side with water is for our healing. And we ask you, we plead the blood because the blood still works.
Yes.
Heal Patrice, go to that heart. And God, the heart that pumped blood, repair it now. Put it back better than before. in the name of Jesus. Lord, open up her eyes, Lord. Let her have mobility in her body. Let her have a strength back. Let her be able to walk. Let her have a testimony to tell one there was nobody but God. Let the family see the power of God in Jesus' name. Heal it and give one the strength. Let him know it's in the hand of the Lord now. Pick Wendell up. Lord, lift him up now. Let him know, God, you took care of the house. Yes. You took care of everything for him. Because you had a plan. You knew he was coming to you, Jesus. Yes. You knew he was going to give his life to you. You knew he was going to turn around. Yes. And God, you got things in store for him, good things in store for this man now in Jesus' name. You can bring his family back to him in unity. Yes. You can fix it. And we call it done right now. In Jesus' name. It's sealed with amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you, Dad. Thank you, Tracy.
God bless you. Put it there. How many know the blood still works?
Amen.
But you're going to see when you got somebody spiritual, it means a whole lot. Amen?
That's
why we got to do spiritual things. You can't get caught up in this world system. Amen? Y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
Go to 2 Kings 5, if you will. Second Kings 5. Amen. Lord, at the first verse. The best I've seen, spiritual things. My God. God gonna touch every headache that come up on you. Every stomachache, how they must say, God out of our body shop, one more thing. What you say, Evangelist? I say? You got a bad headache. Oh my God. I got out of my body shop. I'm going to go. I speak. I want God to tell you to touch your own knees. Lay hands on yourself and plead the blood and speak healing over you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Stress. Hallelujah. Pressure. Anxiety, frustration, be gone. In the name of Jesus, peace come to her mind, peace in her body, soul, and spirit. Peace all around her. Wherever she tread her feet, peace is there in Jesus' name. And healing is up on her. Headache, subside in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. God bless your soul, God. Lord will confirm himself.
Amen.
He will confirm himself, Dr. Shepherd. Are y'all ready?
Yes, sir.
2 Kings, the 5th chapter. Amen. I'll read a little bit, but it's going to explain to you, and you're going to see the power of God. Yeah, amen?
Yes, yes.
I'm not going to read all. I'm going to skip down a little bit and do some things. Amen.
Right.
Now Naaman, commander of the army of the king of Syria, was a great and honorable man in the eyes of his master. Amen. Because by him the Lord had given victory to Syria. Amen. He was also a mighty man, Lord have mercy, of valor. But a leper. Amen. How many know back in the day leprosy was a bad disease to have?
Yes,
kind of like AIDS now.
Yes.
Kind of like cancer now. It's kind of like heart disease now. It's kind of like hepatitis and all those type of diseases that come up on you. Amen. Leprosy was a bad disease. Not that it did so much. It just you were just unclean.
Yes, that's right.
And when you come around people, you had to say unclean.
Uh-huh.
How many of y'all like to come around folks now and say unclean? Uh-huh. You got a cold, unclean. You got diabetes, is it sleeping up on down clean? Women going on their cycle, going around unclean. Okay? You don't want to say that, amen. Unclean, amen. Oh, Lord, So things have changed a whole lot since back then, amen.
Amen.
Man, you running around here, got a sore on your back, running around here, unclean. Lord have mercy, unclean, amen. You got bad teeth in your mouth, unclean. All right, let me move on, amen. And the Syrians had gone out on a raid and had brought back captive a young girl from the land of Israel. How many know it's bad to take somebody from where they already is?
Sure.
To go in and take your house and take your children, amen. To take your wife, to take your husband, amen. Amen. To take you, amen, from where you are at, amen. That's a bad thing, amen.
Yeah.
They took the little girl. My God. How do you know it's a bad thing? It makes you feel, when you know you're doing right. Oh. And like bad things still happen. Lord have mercy. I don't know who I'm talking to. When you're doing right, you know you're doing right. It like bad things still happen to you.
Yes, sir.
Oh, will you still trust him?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Will you still depend on
him? Yes, sir.
Will you still lean on him?
Yes, sir.
When all your world is turned upside down.
Yes,
Lord
sir.
Have mercy.
Yes.
When you know you've been doing good, you're paying your tithes, you're going to church, you're living right, you're treating everybody right, you're giving them love, and yet and still, you stomped on, trumped on, mistreated, and misused, oh my God. You call it on the Lord, you feeling his power, he's waking you up in the night, talking to you, and yet and still, by more than everything,
on,
your world turned upside down. What you do then? What are you going to do then?
Yeah.
When the power is gone, amen.
All right.
I'm going to turn your electric off. And you know you're asking for a little extension, and they said no to you. And they always have given you one.
My Lord.
What you going to do? What you going to do? When you're singing and preaching and clapping your hands, sweating, giving God all the praise you know to give him. When you're fasting and giving him all your standing your word till you fall asleep,
yes,
and something still go wrong, what you going to do then?
Come on now.
Are you going to yet remain spiritual? Are you going to get like the devil, get grilled and grumpy, all down in your sins and start over all over here? Amen.
Oh, no.
Let me get out of here.
No, Pastor.
Okay, but look at this little girl that was captured. Amen. She was in the right place. You could be in the right place at the right time and something still go wrong.
Yep.
Don't let nobody tell you something bad can't happen in a good place. The devil is a lie.
No, that's right.
But I got something to tell you, but that ain't me. Come on. Oh, Jesus is going to give us a victory.
Yes.
So
yes.
We already got the victory, wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
That's it.
She waited on Naaman's wife. The woman, they took the little girl so she can work for the commander's wife. How many know somebody always want to work you for cheap labor?
Uh-huh.
Oh, nobody saying up in here. Yeah. I don't know if y'all didn't work for cheap labor.
Yeah.
I didn't work for $1.60 an hour.
That's cheap labor.
I didn't work for 2 cents a bale on hauling hay. And hay is heavy and it's bad. 2 cents a bale. I know some work for a penny a bale. I didn't understand a penny. Some of them work for half a cent a bale. Y'all ain't heard me. Just to buy some shoes. Stay out there all day long for $6. If you don't get the hay haul, you don't get nothing. Stay out there all day crunching on bologna and press ham and cheese and crackers, amen. Hoping you can haul some hay, amen.
Yes, sir. My God.
Out there hauling pup wood, amen. Giving you about $10 or $15 a load, amen. Hell, y'all ain't saying that. That wood is heavy. Lord, have mercy.
Heavy.
You get down, once you get down your back, you ain't no good no more, amen.
Yes, sir.
Let me get out of there. That's a bad story, amen.
Come on. Drink fast.
Yeah. Then she said to the mistress, if only my master were with the prophet, who is in Samaria, for he would heal him of his leprosy. How many know you got to be around the right
all
folks?
Right, all right.
Sometimes you ain't connected to the right people.
That's right.
You can be around money all day, but still not connected to the right people.
That's right.
Right.
You can be around folks that tell you know on everything. All you need to do is be around one person and give you your first hit. And your whole world turn upside down. When you walk in the bank, they quit looking at you as a person. And they saying, Muslim missing you, amen. Walk in there and put $100,000 in that silk, they start calling you Muslim. Walk in there and put $50,000 in that silk, they don't start calling you Muslim, amen.
All right.
You can walk in there and put $10,000 in there and watch them call you Muslim, amen. Tell you what you do. Go to the restaurant and tip the waitress $20 and see if they start coming to your table all the time. They'll give you everything you need. They give you extra tea, they give you carry out, they give you more than you can carry. Amen.
That's right.
See, everybody come alive on that. Well, how do you like to be on the receiving end of that? God giving you stuff like that. Y'all don't like that. But how do you like to be on the giving end? A lot of people don't want to give.
We want to give.
But it's better to give. Y'all already preaching, amen. But look here. And Naaman went and told his master, said, thus and thus said the girl who is from the land of Israel, because of Syria and Israel is two different places, two different countries, amen.
All right.
Israel is one of the Jews and Syria is one of the Syrians, amen. But they're two different places, amen. But they're close in close proximity to one another, amen.
All right.
Then the king of Syria said, go down and I will send a letter to the king of Israel. See, back then, kings had to send letters to each other. Y'all are hearing me.
Come on.
So he departed and took with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 shekels of gold, and 10 changes of gold. See, the man didn't go empty-handed. A lot of people now go empty-handed. You say, this go on a trip, they expect you to buy them clothes, buy them shoes, buy them food, and buy their room. They don't help with no gas. Don't help you drive. They don't do nothing. They just ride. Sleep and snow. Amen? But this man came to give. Amen?
All right.
And he brought the letter to the king of Israel, which said, now be advised, when this letter come to you, that I have sent Naaman, my servant, to you, that you may heal him of his leprosy. See, if a person not spiritual, they don't understand spiritual things.
All right.
Now you watch what's going to happen next, amen? And it happened when the king of Israel read the letter that he tore his clothes and said, am I God to kill or make alive that this man sent a man to me to heal him of his leprosy? Therefore, please consider and see how he seeks a quarrel with me. See, he thought the man would want to start a fight with him.
Yeah.
But the man was trying to get help for the man. But he was talking to the wrong man. He was talking to the king, but the king had a man in his place that was able to get a prayer through. You understand?
Right.
Well, sometimes when you talk to the wrong person, you may get no prayer through. But let me tell you something. Well, a man or woman of God, all they got to do is hear.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
If you're spiritual, you'll hear. Amen.
That's right. Come on.
You'll hear. Amen. Right. You'll hear in your spirit. Check this out. So it was when Elisha, the man of God, heard that the king of Israel had torn his clothes.
All right.
That he sent to the king saying, why have you torn your clothes? Please let him come to me, and he shall know that there is a prophet in Israel. Lord have mercy.
All right.
How many of y'all gonna let folks know that you saved in your territory?
All right.
How many of y'all gonna let sin going around you and you let somebody know there's somebody saved in this place?
All right.
I like what she said with a testimony. Told the teacher I got to go pray.
Yeah.
She let somebody know in that classroom the devil ain't taking over this class.
I know that's right.
It's somebody saved in here. Amen. You better know, devil, you finna get up out of here. Because when I get through praying, you gonna either get right or you gonna get out of here.
I know that's right.
Come on.
Then Naaman went with his horses and chariot, and he stood at the door of Elisha's house.
Uh-huh.
And Elisha sent a messenger to him, saying, go and wash in the Jordan 7 times, and your flesh shall be restored to you, and you shall be clean. But Naaman became furious and went away and said, indeed, I said to myself, he will surely come out to me and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God and wave his hand over the place and heal the leprosy. See, when you ain't spiritual, you don't even know how spiritual things work.
Uh-huh. All right.
Everybody, when they get sick, want to come and stand in the prayer line and want the preacher, a woman of God, to lay hands on them. You don't have to always lay hands on nobody.
That's right.
You can just speak a word. You don't even have to be where they at. And something happened. See, God worked in an amazing way. He didn't even let the man of God come out and meet the man that was sick. The man that was sick didn't even get to see the man that prayed for him.
Uh-huh.
The man that was praying for him didn't even look at the man that was sick. He spoke a word over the sickness and told him what to do. Matter of fact, he told him to go to the river and dip 7 times. Because 7 is the number of completion. You understand?
Because
when you do what God says 7 times, you're going to be healed.
That's right.
Are you all right, daughter?
Her back.
I bind the devil today. Yeah. You see, God is saying something about healing today. My God. Everybody get a prayer. Go put your crystal on her. In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
up and down her spine. I speak on her muscles. The devil don't want her to receive today. I bind him right now.
Right now.
In Jesus' name. How about shock? Brother Lobosi, be good up outside. Heal her now. My God. Heal her now. In the name of Jesus. The devil don't want this to go through, but the devil is alive.
Yeah, he is.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Heal now. Heal now.
Right now.
Heal now.
Right now, Lord.
Heal now.
Right now, Lord.
Use your faith, daughter.
Right
heal
now.
Heal now.
Lord.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Pray later. Hallelujah. Time out. Bring a letter, sit here on this altar. Come here. Sit here. Come here and sit here. Come here and let us sit here. I bind this devil. I bind this devil. I bind this devil. I bind this devil. Sit right here. I bind this devil. I bind this devil. I bind this devil.
Yeah, right now, Lord.
I bind his enemy. Hallelujah. I bind him now.
Right now.
In the name of Jesus. I want everybody that can pray, get a prayer through. I bind this spirit right now.
Bind him right now.
And then go back to. I bind shot. God of old sheep. He got about shot. Heal now in Jesus' name. Come on out of here. Loose him. In Jesus' name, Lord forgive us, deliver and set us free, right now. In Jesus' name, do it now. She sent it to all. Do it now. She laid it to all. Right now, everything got to drop off. Right now, in Jesus' name, touch her now. Touch her now. Touch her now. Woman, you take up your bed and walk. You take up your bed and walk. Young man, get us some tissue over there. Get us some tissue behind you. Take up your bed and walk. Yes, Lord. Give her a tissue. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 I want you to stand. I want you to stand up on your feet. Come on, peace in your mind. Come on. Let go of all of those stuff trying to come back to your mind. Hallelujah. Jesus, all the hardship, all the things you've been through. Come on. We brought you here. To do something for you. Any form of sickness in your body, I bind it in the name of Jesus. Let go. I want you to stand up on your feet. Stand up on your feet. And you be able to walk back to your seat. Come on. Come on. Walk with God. Walk. Walk. Walk in Jesus' name. Walk. Walk. Every step you take, I'm healed in Jesus' name. Come on. Come on. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. My. Hallelujah. Keep on calling on Jesus, dog. And you also need to soak your back. You need to treat your back. Amen. And you don't abuse your back. Amen. You don't be staying a long time either, nowhere. Amen. Where are you living at?
Timpson.
That's where you living at now? Y'all just drove up here today?
Yeah.
Y'all find, how'd y'all wind up here? You just, God,
yeah. Honestly, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm glad you ain't
going to be alone.
God bless you. I had to find out myself. Yeah. I mean, that, y'all got to understand, Tiffin ain't no short distance here.
That's right.
You know, we were going to one church, and we didn't get there in time going to this other, and I'm like, God, wherever you want us to go, you're going to have to send us.
So he landed us here.
We got here. That's all I can say.
Yeah. That's but God. Wow. That's but God. God needed you to pray for this young lady. That's why he got
her
here.
That's why he got her here.
She ain't here by accident.
My.
She ain't here by accident.
Spiritual thing.
Yeah,
Pastor. Spiritual thing.
Hey.
If I heal it. I'm about to throw this mic.
Don't throw it this way, throw it that way.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Shepherd, I almost lost my. But he dipped some time. Y'all hear me?
Wow.
That's not what he's supposed to do. But he didn't like it.
We're going to get some more.
How many know you don't always like what the information
is? Yeah,
So I'm almost. I'm gonna skip down a little bit. Skip down, amen. Lord have mercy. To the 13th verse. I'm trying to get to you. And his servant came near and spoke to him, said, "My father, if the prophet have told you something great, would you not have done it?" Amen. Oh, so when you go up. He was trying to say how come he couldn't wash in the other lake, in the other river, like in the mountains and stuff, in the other rivers, amen? Powerhouse and Avenue. And he was trying to say how come he couldn't wash in those other rivers. And because they clean, but the Jordan was a nasty river, uh-oh. How many know God would take something nasty and make it clean? And some people want to come to this church because they think it's a little hot. But her blessing was in this church.
That's right.
Y'all didn't hear me. Amen. He said, "Wash and be clean." So he went down and dipped 7 times in the Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God. And his flesh was restored like the flesh of a little child.
Right,
and he was clean. Right. How many know if you just obey God?
Obey God.
He dipped 7 times in Philippa. In a little nasty river. One that wouldn't be so good you want to put your feet in the swimming. But he dipped in it 7 times.
Right.
You couldn't see the bottom of this one. You couldn't see the fish swimming in this one. But he still dipped in it. If you want something from God, you go where you got to go.
That's right.
Come on.
He sent you to the house of the disciples to get what you need. Amen. I've been noticing you in church. You ain't had not one season since you've been in here.
That's
right. Not since I've been in here. Not in church. Amen. But look at you sitting here. That's about my shot. Y'all know what
y'all Lord.
He want to heal. He want to deliver. He want to give peace up in here.
Come on.
I've been looking at the faithlessness of Sister Belinda been coming. God healing her. Delivering and set some things, turning some things around for her. Set her alive and all. Then the devil tried to take that woman out. Y'all don't understand that.
Yeah.
The devil had a death sentence on her to take her out young. Amen. But the Lord said no. Amen.
Right.
He said prayer for that woman. Amen. And said she should live.
And not die.
I don't think y'all heard it.
Well,
now, let's move.
Right.
But see, sometimes when God moves, folks think they ought to get money for it. Uh-oh. Well.
Read, Pastor.
Let me finish this out so y'all will understand what's going on here. Let me move down to around the 16th verse.
All right.
Now I'm gonna go on to the 15th verse so y'all understand it. And he returned to the man of God in all his age, and came and stood before him. And he said, indeed now, I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Now, therefore, please take a gift from your servant. But he said, as the Lord lives, before whom I stand, I will receive nothing. And he urged him to take it, but he refused. Lord, have mercy. So Laban said, then if not, please let your servant be given 2 mules loads of, oh my God, 2 mules load of earth for your servant, will no longer offer either burnt offering or sacrifice to other gods, but to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Yet in this thing, many of these things may the Lord pardon your servant. Amen. So pardon means take it all away, don't it?
Yeah.
When my master goes into the temple of Ramon to worship there, and he leans on my hand, and I bow down in the temple of Ramon. When I bow down in the temple of Ramon, may the Lord please pardon your servant in these things. Then he said to them, go in peace. So he departed for a short distance. Now, I want you to check something out. Now, when you go in peace, somebody always want to mess with your stuff.
Uh-huh.
Y'all ain't hear me.
Yeah.
When a word been spoken, leave something alone, why would you go try to do something else? When the wheel been invented, quit trying to reinvent the wheel. Amen?
That's right.
But Gehazi, the servant of Elisha, the man of God, said, look, my master has, oh my God, has spared Naaman, this Syrian, while not receiving from his hand what he brought. But as the Lord lives, I will run after him and take something from him. So Gehazi pursued Naaman. When Naaman saw him running after him, he got down from the chariot to meet him and said, is all well? And he said, all is well. My master has sent me, saying, indeed, just now, 2 young men of the son of the prophet have come to me from the mountain, or Ephraim. Please give a talent of silver and 2 chains of garment. Look at him, he's lying. It's a bad thing to lie about spiritual things.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So Laban said, please take 2 talents. And he urged him, and he bound 2 talents of silver into 2 bags. With the chain of garment. Now, what I'm going to fast forward and let you know something. Look down to round the 26th verse. Then he said to him, did my heart go with you when a man turned back from his chariot to meet you? Is it time to receive money and to receive clothing, olive groves, a vineyard, sheep and oxen, male and female servants. Therefore, the leprosy of Naaman shall cling to you and your descendants forever. And he went out from the presence, oh my God, leprosy and the whitest snow. And what I'm trying to say is because Gehazi lied and did what his master told him not to do, the leprosy that was on Naaman came to him. See, you got to watch what you do. When you do some things that a person has been delivered from and you don't want to get what they had because they got money, sometimes that stuff will turn on you. The Lord says your riches sometimes will turn on you. Money will turn on you. Amen. Y'all didn't hear me that, didn't you? Yeah. We're almost finished. Go over to Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 4, and I'm almost 1 Corinthians 4. We're almost finished. And then what is this little instruction to y'all today? That's all. What I want y'all to do is know that your healing is here. I want you to know that when God speaks something, it's already done. What God done today, he proved to us today that he's here. He's God with us. The man that I seen had a headache. This man had a backache. Amen. I saw how God worked for us on yesterday. God is a healer. Amen. He is a healer. Amen. Yeah. The first verse. Let a man so consider us as servants of Christ, as stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required in stewards that one be found faithful. Amen. How many of y'all know we be faithful?
That's right.
With me, it is very small thing that I should be judged by you or by any human court. In fact, I do not even judge myself, my God.
All right.
I know of nothing against myself. Yes, I am not justified by this. But he who judges one in the Lord, therefore judge nothing before the time until the Lord comes. You can't judge nobody before the time comes.
Yes.
Amen. But I want you to jump down. Jump down. We're almost finished. I promise you, we're almost finished. Amen. Jump down to the 8th verse. You are already full. How many know once you got God, you're full?
Yeah. Yeah,
right. You are already rich. Amen. Yeah. You don't have to seek out the money. You are already rich. You have reigned as king without us. Amen. And indeed, I could wish you did reign, that we are all also might reign with you. For I think that God has dismayed us. Amen. Displaced us. The apostle laughed as men condemned to death. Amen? For we have been made a spectacle. How many know sometimes you made to be a spectacle? Mm-hmm. To the world. Uh-huh. Yep. Both to angels and to men. Amen? We are fools for Christ's sake. How many know you got to be a fool for Christ?
Yeah. That's right.
Come on now.
But you are wise in Christ. Y'all, I'm trying to help somebody.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
We are weak, but you are strong. Lord have mercy.
Yeah.
You are disgusted, but you are dishonored. Amen.
Uh-huh.
You are distinguished, but you are dishonored. Amen. To the present hour, we both hunger and thirst, and we are poorly clothed, Lord have mercy, and beaten and homeless. Sometimes we're that way. Amen. And we labor, working with our own hands, being revealed, be blessed, being persecuted. We endure, being dismayed. Amen. Disframed. Amen. We entreat. We have been made as the filth of the world, the Oscar of all things until now. Amen? Because the power of God brings us back where we need to be. Amen?
That's right.
I dare you to look at somebody and say, I'm healed.
I'm healed.
I'm going to do spiritual things.
I'm going to do spiritual things.
I'm going to follow the Spirit. Because when I follow the Spirit,
I get my health.
I'm rich.
Even though I look poor.
I'm distinguished. I'm distinguished. Even though you want to dishonor me.
Even though you want to dishonor me.
You bring me down to the earth.
You bring me down to the earth.
Lord, raise me up.
Lord, raise me up.
I'm going somewhere.
In the Lord.
Nobody can do me.
Like the Lord.
Because the Spirit.
Because the Spirit is leading guide me.
Thank you, Lord. For your spirit.
Your spirit.
Bring all things back to my remembrance.
Your spirit.
Testifies of Jesus.
Testify your spirit.
Know the way back to heaven.
Your spirit.
Don't take me back.
Your spirit.
Get me up out of the grave.
Your spirit.
Give me a peace of mind.
Your spirit.
Turn my world around.
Your spirit.
Lift me up.
Your spirit, give me strength.
Your spirit, give me joy.
Your spirit, heal my body.
Your spirit, give me all I need. I want to go with the Lord. On my side. Nobody can do me like the Lord. Nobody can pick me up.
Like the Lord.
He gave me the word.
The word and life.
The Spirit. The Spirit.
I can't see.
It's like the wind. But I know it's there.
Because
it works for me. The Spirit. Walks in this hot box. Your spirit. Bought an air conditioner in here. Your spirit, go fix it for us. Your spirit is going down a bad mood. Healing that heart. Your spirit healing that back. Your spirit paying your bills. Your spirit fixing your cars. Your spirit putting money in your pocket. Your spirit changing your children. Y'all better sit down. Your spirit. Your spirit. Give me joy. Your spirit. Give me a new outlook. Your spirit is my friend. Your spirit is my brother. Your spirit is there when nobody else is there. Your spirit lay down with me at night. Your spirit, get up with me. Your spirit walks in my house. Your spirit riding my car. Your spirit gets in my closet. Your spirit going to jaw with me. Your spirit going to school with me. Y'all be good.
Y'all be good.
Holy Spirit,
be with me.
I welcome you here to my temple.
I welcome you here to dwell in me.
I welcome you here to be with me. I welcome you here above all things. Because your spirit brings me closer to Jesus. Your spirit is in my spirit, in my soul. Take my prayer from my mouth, go all the way to heaven, bring me back an answer, all the way to the throne. Your spirit. No spirit. Watch out, somebody. All right, y'all.
Thank you, Lord.
Ask the Lord to cover y'all. In Jesus' name. Cover y'all right now. In Jesus' name. Because you are the spirit. Because the presence of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Is here.
Yes, Lord.
Shepherd, give me about 30 seconds. Fast, hit it for me. I want y'all to give it the presence. What now? Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah. This is the living deal. All right, what is here? Come on, yeah.
All right,
Yeah. Come on.
Thank and I pray that everyone about to receive communion, so give them that they're clean, washing with your blood. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Funky Million. Shake the juice up. The bread's on the top, juice is on the bottom. Hold up when you drink it. We'll read the scriptures on you, okay? 1 Corinthians 11, 9:26 says, for as often as you drink this, as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's body till he comes. Therefore, whoever eats this bread or drinks this cup in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this reason, many are weak and sick among you, and many sleep. Amen. Take it up here. Given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, go eat the bread. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is a new covenant in my blood. If you walk there, you drink it. Go ahead and drink it in remembrance of me. Mother Burst called. She couldn't make it today, amen. She's taking care of her brother, and she just couldn't get it today, amen. But people want to lift Mother up, amen. I'm going to call it out here a little church, but man, I didn't think about nothing right then. My focus on so much that's going on around us, amen. Y'all be praying for the family that lost their lives in those places and around. You all be safe. Y'all pray to God, amen.
Yeah,
and don't you get upset at people, amen. When you go to the drive through or something and they don't get your food right, be courteous to them, amen. Just tell them, hey, look, you can put my onions on here, you know, it took McDonald's 5 times one time to get my burger right.
It did. Five times.
So Tammy, and all I told them was cut the mustard. No onion.
And
ketchup one time, put onion one time. I think they put mustard in mayo one time. Then I don't think they put nothing on it. They just made a mess. Amen. Sister Tammy said, I'll just go behind the counter and fix it for them. Amen. But they finally got it. Amen. It was Jesus. It wasn't nothing to brag on. Amen. I don't think I thought about it. Amen. Sister Brother, amen. They took them 5 times with blood to get it right. That's a bad thing, amen. Just cut the mustard and cut the onion. That's all you got to do.
Yep.
That's just, and Shepard, how hard is that?
That's simple.
Shepard, I went somewhere last night, I said, put my cherry on the side. The lady put on the side, I mean put it in another dish like they always do. This young lady put them on the side of where I had it in my cup. She said, "You said put it on the side." I said,
God bless you.
You put it on the side, though. You know, if I say put it on the side, you go to the restaurant, I don't mean put it on the side of my plate. Put it on the side in another container.
God bless y'all
today.
Amen.
Anybody got anything to say? Y'all all right today? Anybody got anything to say before you all?
Y'all, that's a wonderful time and a wonderful service.
Amen.
Yeah. I want to say that I thank God that to use you today. I've been waiting to hear your voice. And I thank God that he healed you enough that you're
Able
to preach his gospel.
Amen. Glory.
I petition every member, visitors, everybody to continue to pray for the pastor.
Amen. Glory.
Because, you know, the enemy get mad when you got a good leader.
Amen.
And he can preach.
Yeah.
Well, to shut him down, but you know, that's a strong man there. And also, I want to thank God that we did get the answer from the leader that we can go ahead and put the air conditioning in. That's a blessing right there. That window is shut. I wish they had to let me know. I have a tool that you can unstick it. You know, when you paint, I don't know why they paint it over the window, but okay. And if you can. I'm sticking with this tool. So that's a blessing right there. God is yet still on our side.
Yes, amen. God bless you. Anybody else?
I just want to say, Pastor, first giving honor to God and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And to you and first thing and all the members, ministers, and evangelists in here. My cousin is here.
Hey!
You know what I'm saying? And we, his word says we speak things that
don't
have already work.
That's right.
Right? So, she is here.
Amen.
I got the thing I love about this church that I serve at is that we got some praying folks in here.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
Leave
and the word says prayer changes things. So I know she is changed. She is healed. You know what I'm saying? That was just a little minor setback for a major comeback.
Uh-huh.
You understand what I'm saying? To show the power of God. So I just want to thank everyone for being with me, staying by me. You know, and we all lifted my cousin up in prayer. You understand? And that you know, God is going to go in there and do that miraculous healing. Young lady, on your back also. He did not already done it.
Yeah.
He did not already done it. Young lady, you just walk in it like it's done. You understand? And the more you show God that he did took care of it, the more and more God is going to do for you and your husband. Amen. God bless y'all this morning. Yes, sir.
I was praying the Lord on what he was saying. But I just want y'all to continue to pass you down the Lord with y'all as always.
You know, always.
I love to see my leaders faithful, my dad up there. It's just amazing how God uses you and how you got all these little pastor papers coming up behind you. Including your first lady, she act like you sometimes too.
God,
but we
done
adopted what you say. I just want to thank God for this church. I want to thank God for the church family that I have. I love y'all. I thank y'all for y'all prayers. I know y'all praying when I don't even know y'all praying.
Yes.
But I'm asking y'all to, it's amazing how God works, and it's just amazing how you, the man or woman of God, can show them things concerning you, and he hasn't told you anything. But I'm just asking y'all to, I always speak out loud. I'm not going to press out. I'm not going to go back to spirit of the prince. I'm not going to go back to that. And sometimes the enemy hurt me and still try to call something to come. Make you feel like I'm getting back in that place. But you have to learn to resist him and rebuke him and use all the tools God gave you to get through. But I'm asking y'all to keep my family in prayer.
Yes.
My sister Alice, my brother Horace, her Alice's children, my sisters and brothers. It's just so much going on. The devil don't like you when they're children.
Right. That's right.
The devil don't like it when he uses someone in the family as a mediator to try to help these people solve their problems. But I thank him when he comes to me and tells me to step back and don't say that. But if something happened yesterday, Pastor, I discussed it with the first lady once before, I saw something, and it wasn't good. And I'm praying over that thing concerning the family member. I saw death on this person. I'm starting to see it again.
Well, we speak to the Spirit of God, change that thing. Yeah, yeah. What I want you to do, I want you to write, you might have did it before, write that person's name down.
Yeah.
And just put it back in the box. You wrote it down before?
A long time ago.
Yeah,
that.
Okay. And that's what you to do. So you covered all of the church.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. All right. We get ready. Y'all got some of y'all want to say? I'm glad to have y'all. I know it's amazing how y'all come to go. What church are y'all going to?
God has called me and then my wife here to a ministry called Serenity Ministry for Jesus Christ. And we visit different churches and we'll like record audio of the service and stuff and just share with others what, you know, what other churches are out there. People might be looking for a church home, kind of point them in the right direction. Oh, yeah, there's one of our cards. So if anybody wants to check us out, we have a Facebook page. We have a website, Serenity Ministries, the number 4, JesusChrist.org. And then we have the YouTube channel. So.
Well, thank you. Okay, yeah, I heard Serenity. Yeah. God bless you. Yeah. So y'all go out everywhere, huh?
Yes. Yeah. Mostly in Timpson area, Nacogdoches, we have a bunch for there. We've been to some here in Longview, Tyler. We're headed to Kilgore today to see a church family there and have lunch with them and stuff.
Okay. Well, I know y'all have to get out of here.
Yeah. And two months before that, we went to College Station.
Oh, yeah, that was neat. Yeah, we went to College Station Church.
Then this last month, when he went to Dallas on a vacation and went to a church there.
And now you're down here at Powerhouse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You ain't going to forget Powerhouse.
No, we told the Lord to lead us wherever he wanted to lead us.
Well, so he led us here.
All right, God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
How long y'all been married?
About 3 months, 3 or 4 months.
Almost 5 months.
Yeah, 5 months, I guess.
God bless. Congratulations to y'all.
5 months
now.
Y'all look alike.
Y'all do,
God bless y'all. Congratulations to you. So y'all want to eat lunch with other people, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. We're supposed to meet them at Kilgore at 1, so.
Okay. Well, you better get out here.
Right.
Well, I plead the blood of Jesus over y'all and bless y'all. Okay. Well, yeah, they're going to do something for you.
On behalf of Powerhouse and our pastor and first lady, we're not trying to pay you. We just want to give you a little love token. Appreciate you coming. You could have went anywhere this morning, but we thank God that you chose Powerhouse. And this is from Powerhouse and first lady and the pastor and the Power Knights.
Thank you.
All right.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
Okay.
We're going to get through the slide.
Gifts. Today is first Sunday. It's pastoral aid Sunday. This basket here is for the pastor. And this basket here is for the general fund and tithe in the offering. Amen.
Amen.
And if you have a special, that basket is for the special. You know, and at the end of the quarter, first lady will tally it up and put everything. Because the special is, that's what it says. Special. Something that we're going to try to do for the church. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for coming here today. We thank you for blessing us today, Lord. We thank you for the pastor and the word that you received on today, Lord. Now, Lord, as we get ready to leave from this place, we never from your presence, we ask you to guide us and be with us, Lord. Now, Lord, bless those that are going to give, bless their tithes that they give back, and that it may be returned in 10 times more, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Now, may the God, may the sweet communion rest, rule, and bind with us with forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We may bring you all gifts at this time. You're dismissed.